there, friends. Welcome. Welcome to Homekeepers. I'm so glad to be here. I'm so glad you're there. If this is your first time to see the program, my name is Arthelene Rippy, and we like to deal with issues that affect the home. There's a lot of them. I think we can be on the air really till Jesus comes, and we'll still be dealing with those important issues around the home, that basic unit that God created for any and all society. And I don't have to tell you that it's never been under attack more than it is right now. And so we hope to keep you alerted and to really pay attention to what's happening. One thing that's really happening is the degradation of our educational system. And for that reason, I like to bring on educators who can really point you in the right direction and maybe alert you to things that are going on. For instance, this is in my newspaper yesterday. School grades padded. Now, how would you like your kid to go to a school where the educators, the adults, cheat and bring everybody's grade down so everybody can get through? And here's the second part, but the board votes to pad school grades. I read that with just, I had no words. I was so angry. Well, I plan to have more and more programs about education, so you'll be watching for those. But for today, my guest is Tamara Chilver, and she is an expert homeschool mom. And we will be showing you her website. If you are thinking of homeschooling, because it is growing just rapidly, because there's a lot of parents that are thinking this through, there's all kinds of material available to you, and she will talk about that. So I want you to meet her. And I'm going to join Stephanie in the kitchen just a minute. We're going to fix a strawberry ice cream ice box pie. That's an old term. I remember that when I was younger. So see what she knows about it. But before I join her, I again want to offer you the ABCs of school success. And this item, if you would like to have it, just write for it. If you can give us something, if you can give a gift to keep us on the air, I just pray that you will do that, because that's the way we stay on the air. And so any gift of any amount, but if you really can't do that, I want you to have that along with that New England primer, which will show you what the way our nation started out, teaching our young people to read. And you know what? It was the scripture. It was the word of God. And we've got a lot of problems with our educational system. We're going to try to really address that for you beginning now and the next few weeks. Okay, I've joined Stephanie over here, and I think we've got something that the whole crew is waiting for.
I think everyone's going to be happy today.
Yes. It has a pretzel crust, and we have one here.
Yep, we've taken 2 cups of pretzels. We took a 3/4 cup of butter that was melted and 1/4 cup of brown sugar, put it all in here, and baked it for about 10 minutes at 350. So it's like a crust.
Yeah, and we did that ahead of time.
Yep.
What I'm anxious to test, and this is what we did. I guess you could put them in food processor,
sure,
too. But you get rid of a lot of frustration,
yes,
if you just
banging it this morning.
Oh, boy. Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
And I have a 14-ounce can of condensed milk, and I have a half of an 8-ounce bar of cream cheese, and then I have a 3-ounce package of strawberry gelatin, and I'm going to mix those all together, and you have 2 cups of strawberries that you are going to put in our little food processor there. And
this is our little non-electric.
Yeah. It's easier to clean.
Strawberries are so easy to cut up. I keep them cut up in my fridge because I put them in my Young Power Shake.
Yeah, I try to keep vegetables and fruit cut up in the refrigerator so it's easier for everyone to get to. Seems to get eaten more that way.
That was about 4 ounces of cream cheese, right?
And a 3-ounce package of
I think that's good, or we're going to have soup.
Yeah. Look at that, how well that worked. I love it.
This is a wonderful gizmo. I believe Mr.
This
Keith
smells
sent it
so
to us.
Yep, good.
Fresh strawberries. I'm going to bring this one over here just so people can look at it. But
it's so pretty.
It was in the freezer overnight, except before putting the whipped cream on it this morning.
And we put the whipped cream, and then we put it back in the freezer for about an hour so that the top would get a little frozen.
And guess
too.
What? I'm going to let you cut it.
Okay. Okay, so I have this mixed up. I'm going to put in the strawberries.
That looks so good. I'm going to just taste it
yes.
now. Oh, my word.
How could it be bad?
I mean, no
really.
Way.
It has cream cheese. It has gelatin.
And I was thinking, too, this is one, if you've got company coming or just no reason at all.
No
you
reason
fix it
at all.
A week ahead.
Have it in the freezer.
Put it in the freezer, and then all you do is add the whipping cream.
And if company comes,
and if you
surprise.
Want to, if you want to use Cool Whip, which I'm so opposed to.
Yeah, you
to.
Whipped this up this
uh-huh.
morning.
I'm very cream. Opposed to Cool Whip. I can't figure what it's made of.
Well, I like read, it, so.
Did you ever read the side of it?
So that's, well, that was 3/4 cups of whipping mm-hmm. cream that you whipped up this morning. And we're just gonna pour this in the shell.
And then you're gonna cut
and
it.
And then it freezes.
Do you want me to do that?
Sure.
Do you want to move over here and start?
We'll see how this works out over here.
Just kind of fold this in.
Yep. And then I said, you know, when you pour it in here, there's a little leftover. You just take a spoon, you go to the couch.
And put it in
and
your
you
mouth.
Eat.
Yeah. This one was filled right to the top, and I
yeah.
think there was still a little leftover.
Yeah. I think that's the little bonus plan.
I'm anxious to see how it comes out, though.
It feels like it's
we did one here one time that we just took out of the freezer a little early, right?
You yes, you had put it in the refrigerator. I'm going to blame you for that one.
Oh.
And it came out all mushy.
Yep.
So we made sure this one stayed in the freezer. Ready? Oh, yeah.
Ooh. Ooh.
I told my grandson say, oh, yeah.
How old is he?
7.
No way.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, this is really filling up way past the
yeah.
crust.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, see, now you have something to lick. Hold mm-hmm. to lick. I'm getting these pretzels out of here.
There's a little bit there.
Oh, my goodness. We might have to charge for this.
This has got to be in the top 10. And I'll tell you what, that pretzel crust gives it a little bit of a salty.
Oh, yeah.
Have we ever done any better, anything
you
better than this?
You all want this.
Uh-huh.
Without a doubt.
Oh, my word. I have no vocabulary.
Okay, this is a keeper. I'm uh-huh. making this for our next get-together.
Mm-hmm.
We're just going to sit here
and eat. We're just going to stand here and eat it, okay? But... the information for this recipe is coming up on your screen, and really, we're kind of speechless because it is
seriously
so good. But you can have that, and then I want you to meet my guest, and we're going to talk about education.
Oh,
so
we have a
very
guest.
Important.
We have a guest. We forgot.
Yeah.
If you would like a copy of today's recipe, please send your request along with a gift of $5 or more to Homekeepers, P.O. Box 6922, Clearwater, Florida 33758.
Welcome. Welcome to Homekeepers. I think at the top of the program I called you Tamara, but it's Tamara, right?
Yes.
Either name is very pretty, like you are. Welcome.
Oh, thank you.
Glad to have you back. How long has it been since you've been on the program?
I'm thinking 5 or 6 years. It's been a while.
And we certainly always welcome homeschool moms on this program, and I've had so many write and say they appreciate it, that a lot of times just women who stay home are looked down upon. Mm-hmm. And then they see somebody who actually homeschools their children, and they think, why? And you have 5 children, and I guess that's another why.
Well, because God wants me to, for mm-hmm. sure. I know that. But I love it, too. I really do. I wouldn't have it any other way right now.
That's a very good reason. Give us the age span of your children.
Okay. Well, all the ages or just the
yeah,
span?
Yeah, let's have all
okay.
of them.
Because I told you before, I have to concentrate. Okay, I have almost 3-year-old, a 4-year-old, a 10-year-old, 11, and 19-year-old.
So they're really, they are really spread out.
Yes.
And you say that God called you to do that. I have no doubt about that. But what led up to that? Because you've kind of done it all the way through with the 19. Mm-hmm. You started with the one who's 19 now.
Yes. Right. Well, I was a public school teacher.
Oh, okay.
For 6 years, and I also tutored elementary school kids, and I have that's my background. Was my degree was in elementary curriculum, and in school I started seeing things that were little red flags to me that were just socialization issues, the peer issues, bullying, the safety. And I kept coming home to my husband saying, I don't know if I want our son, because he was 4 at the time, even in my classroom, even if I was a teacher.
Wow.
And I was at a good school. It was a top 10 school in the state of Florida. Mm-hmm. So I was in a great school. And even for me, which I thought I was an effective teacher, but there were so many things going on in my classroom that were beyond my control.
Yes, and you're restricted, right, as a teacher?
Very. With discipline, right? And choosing curriculum. And when you have children into your classroom that are from families that are not very supportive or teaching them values, and then they're with children that have other kinds of family mm-hmm. values. And so you have this clash. And I just kept thinking of my 4-year-old that last year I was in the classroom. I didn't want him in a classroom, even if it was mine, because there were many issues and things I could not control. And
I think that's such an eye-opening situation, because that was 15 years ago.
Yes.
Now, they weren't teaching same-sex marriage. They weren't teaching all kinds of
right.
absolute degradation mm-hmm. to children beginning very, very young. So with your background as a teacher, you weren't really overwhelmed teaching.
No, but you know, the enemy is very good at still putting that fear in any mother, in any parent when it comes to homeschooling. Mm-hmm. I've seen it across the board. If you've been a classroom teacher, or this is brand new to you, homeschooling in education, because I still had that fear coming home to my own son. I kept thinking, what? I was mm-hmm. trained to teach a classroom.
Right.
I wasn't trained to teach one.
And you were experienced.
Very experienced. And I still was nervous about teaching my own. It's just that fear, and I really think it's from the mm-hmm. enemy.
Absolutely, because the enemy doesn't want your children to learn biblical values.
Right.
I want to get this website up now. We'll leave it up for the rest of the show, and I'll tell you why. It's one of the best websites I have ever seen in my life. I just have to congratulate you.
Thank you so much.
And if you have any qualms about homeschooling and you believe that the Lord might be leading you that direction, I really encourage you to sit down and go through that website. Just take a little time. She's got so many good things in there. And homeschooling from the bookend, the curriculum and so forth, and this might be a controversial phrase, but it's big business. It's huge.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I understand this conference or convention that comes to Orlando is huge.
Yes.
And there's every kind of curriculum you can set up for your own child.
Right. I went there in May. My family went. Mm-hmm. And it's booming, too. Mm-hmm. Homeschooling is growing so fast.
Do you have any recent stats on that?
Yes. The most recent one is that homeschooling is growing 7% faster than public school enrollment.
And 7%
faster. And they expected a double in the next 10 years. 4% of all school-aged children in the United States are homeschooled.
And you know what is so sad? Are those children who don't have that opportunity, I mm-hmm. think. First place, the Bible says, you shall teach these things to your children.
Right. Impress upon their heart.
Every parent, grandparent, they should really be the primary teachers.
Yes.
No question.
And they are.
Mm-hmm.
And that's
yes.
one thing that I think parents don't think. they can homeschool. I hear all the time, oh, I can't homeschool. I feel God's leading me there, but I can't. I'm not a teacher. And I just want to say that's a lie, mm-hmm. because you are a teacher. You're your child's most important teacher since they've been born. Mm-hmm. You've taught them to walk and talk and love and know about God. And you're their most important teacher they will ever have. For some reason, we just think when they turn 5, oh, we need a piece of paper to say I'm a teacher. I can't teach anymore. I guess
right,
in a way.
I have talked to more than one who, when they get to those high school age, oh, I can't do that, I can't do that. Mm-hmm. And then they'll find they could.
Yes.
They took it one step at a time and the materials are there. Now this, you have written, How to Teach Your Child. Mm-hmm. And this will be on her website as well. There's another book I saw on your website. It's not Homeschool for Dummies, it's not that rude, but it was like if you're afraid to homeschool.
On the fence, if you're on the fence of homeschooling, mm-hmm. and that's what it addresses, because I feel like right now with homeschooling booming, so mm-hmm. many parents are right there on the fence. They're looking at it, they're apprehensive about public school now, maybe private school's not an option economically, mm-hmm. and so they're looking like, what are the other options? And I had emailed you that book, On the Fence About Homeschooling, all of a sudden started booming because all these parents are just selling a lot because parents are right there on the fence, mm-hmm. and they're a little nervous, and that's what that book addressed, because just if God is calling you to it, He will see you through it. Mm-hmm. He will equip you.
I've noticed the homeschool kids that have been in and out of the studio for the last more than 20 years, they're mature.
Yes.
They are comfortable with adults. They can converse. And before you get all upset about that, in my estimation, what could be dumber than putting a 5-year-old in a room several hours a day with 30 more 5-year-olds?
Right.
That's
right.
Not very good socialization.
Yes.
And I've noticed, too, homeschool parents have a little different bend the way they think, and this is good for anybody and everybody, whether you homeschool or not. They can, everything is education to them.
Yes.
You know, if you driving down the street, you point out a sign to that toddler, that they just have this, everything's education is kind of just inborn impulse they have.
Right, like homeschooling becomes your lifestyle. It's not something you do
right.
just school hours during the day. It's your life, and mm-hmm. and it embraces the family and works to your family's schedules and your family's lifestyle, and that's just, it makes it so wholesome. It just mm-hmm. brings the family, like I see siblings just become so close. They're truly best friends, mm-hmm. and you don't have this sibling rivalry and other issues that families have that are away from each other all day, and then they come home at night, and then there's no time to connect because there's mm-hmm. homework, and there's baths, and there's dinner, and then bedtime, and they don't have that connection that when kids grow up together.
What you're talking about is so foreign to most people.
Right.
Because they can't understand. That would be questioned. That's just the way life is. Okay, describe your typical day. Now, I know that yours changes a lot because I have heard from other homeschool families that when younger ones come along, as they have in your family, the older ones become pretty good tutors.
Definitely.
For the younger
and
ones.
And I've seen that. Because I do want to say for all the moms that may be watching and say, oh, well, I only have one or two, mm-hmm. you know, I don't even think I can do it. But it's like God gives you the grace every time. And if you have a larger family, because when I had one or two, I thought, oh, I can never homeschool mm-hmm. if I had 3 or 4 or 5. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting that God just teaches you the patience and the grace every time. And the babies become the main lesson mm-hmm. when those seasons of life. Like we may pull back from some of the studies. They still have their independent work, but the babies just helping mom and learning my sons, I have 4 boys and 1 girl. She's my youngest, and they're just going to be, I think, the best parents because they know everything about real life parenting mm-hmm. and taking care of others.
Now, what's a typical day for
okay.
you? You're 19-year-olds out of high school by now.
Yes.
But you're teaching 4 children. What's the routine like?
Well, they have, my kids, my older two are very independent, and my younger two I'm just doing preschool with. So my kids help me. They each have preschool activities to do. My older ones with the little ones. And then when the older children have, with homeschooling now, it's so different. There's so many video programs, online programs, mm-hmm. and they have a lot of independent time working. And when they're working independently, then I'm with the toddlers and the little ones doing preschool activities. And then when I'm working with the older ones, I flip-flop and I give them little educational stations or games, like building toys. And one trick a homeschool mom of eight taught me a long time ago is you pull out boxes of toys that they normally do not play with for the little ones. And you just have like a box of special toys, and when it's school time, when you're busy working with the older children, you give them those box of toys, so they're special. And then once school's done,
so
you put those up.
So that's their school.
Yes, during the time. And so I just flip-flop back and forth, but it is amazing. And when you were talking about high school, how parents are so worried or concerned about going to high school and teaching older kids with all the video programs and the online programs mm-hmm. now, it is really very easy if you just look for the right curriculum to match your child.
That was going to be my next question. Where do you think, I know that online is quite popular in college.
Yes.
Where is that going? That, to me, could be huge one day.
I know. Well, one of my friend's daughters, she's getting her AA, and she never actually attended a class, and it's from a college that is in Fort Myers. And
now, there are things built into those. They can't cheat, right?
Right. She just goes to school to take her test, but she submits all her work online and everything. And I thought that was very interesting because it shows because with high school, so much stuff is online now.
That's where it's going.
Yes, and yeah. so is college.
Now, do your children take standardized tests from time to time?
Now, in Florida, it's not required. Some states, it's required. So I do not because...
Well, you are a teacher.
Yes, and I feel like a test isn't going to show me if they're progressing. It's their daily work mm-hmm. and their tests with me. That's what we're learning on is going to show me if there's progress being made, because we don't require, or the state doesn't require it right now. But I don't see any need to take standardized tests if you're not required to, because you can see their progress.
You know, that's interesting because Florida, I don't know about other states, but Florida, it's in the newspapers very frequently, and teachers are unhappy because they just have to teach and train to that test.
Exactly. That's a big
concern
right now.
That's not the full picture, right, what they're learning.
Right. It's not. And teachers are very frustrated with it because I have friends that are still in the classroom teaching, and they're very frustrated that these demands and the Common Core and all these things coming out, and they have to teach more to the test. And it's basically not giving children that individualized instruction anymore. It's teaching everybody as a group, like everybody is the same. And that's not real life.
That's not good.
Mm-mm.
In case you just tuned in, I'm talking to Tamara Chilver, and the inspiration, the information is on your screen, also inspiration. As I mentioned earlier, one of the finest websites I've ever seen. If you are at all curious, even curious, or thinking a little bit about homeschooling, I encourage you to go there. Now, how well prepared will your children be for college if they choose to go?
I think more prepared. Because, and I was reading up on the statistics, and the recent statistics is, and it's about 46% of high school children attend college. That's from school settings. And 76% was homeschool children attend college. So it is higher. And I think colleges love homeschool children because they, instead of giving a cookie cutter application, now there's more room for mentorships that they can show in missionary trips and volunteer positions and work experience, because mm-hmm. homeschool students high school students that are homeschooled, they're not spending all day in the night studying. When they're done with their work, they're out there in the real world, and colleges love that. They love looking at their applications with all these experiences.
I had one homeschool mom on several years ago, and the homeschool class, the day is a lot shorter, and they're learning more basically, but it's because so much time is wasted. So this girl was getting all of her school done, work done 2 or 3 hours, and then set her sights on being a great pianist. And she took piano, and she had hours to practice, so they can really, more than any other setting, they can really pursue the passion that they have or whatever God's put in their heart or whatever their talent might be.
Yes.
There's a lot of time wasted.
I wrote that. I don't know if you saw, I have a book out, Simplify Your Homeschool Day, and it's all the time-saving tips I learned. And that was the premise of this book, is all you can pursue your passions. Homeschooling gives you that freedom to be flexible with your own family schedule, but also to pursue your own passions.
And that's on the website. I encourage you to go there. And you've also written this, How to Teach Your Child. That should be absolutely invaluable to you. Here's something that's disturbing, and I wonder if there's anything in your life that has put up a red flag. There's a family who came here from Germany because Germany said that their children could not be homeschooled. Mm-hmm. So they come to America, and guess what? Our Attorney General has given them a hard time. I understand, or at least the Justice Department's given them a hard time about homeschooling in America. There's so many things going on that are frightening. Have you given that any thought?
Yes, and homeschool parents are aware of this, and
they
see it on the sites and talking about it, even at convention, the mm-hmm. big homeschool convention, parents were talking about that, and that is a concern because we believe in that freedom to make that choice for our child. Like, a parent protects their child, and we love our child more than anybody else, and we appreciate that decision for the education, because education is mm-hmm. a big decision, and parents want that freedom to make that decision for their children.
Well, the way the nation is going, I think there's cause for concern.
Mm-hmm.
But I also know that there are organizations with Christian lawyers that are going to go to bat for the homeschoolers. And another thing, if you want to come against it, you better be careful, because homeschool parents are so determined. You'd have a fight on, they would have a fight that they've never, ever envisioned.
Yes.
So
I agree.
But I don't know the inspiration I've had. I've got about 3 seconds to tell this, but I had a homeschool child on here. She's about seventh grade, and she makes freezer jelly. Over
okay.
there. I've never made jelly in my life. But the interesting thing was, when the show was over, she starts cleaning up the kitchen. She just knew what to do. I thought, there is your homeschool child. And I'm going to be doing more programs on education coming up very, very shortly. I hope you'll pay attention, because Christian kids should be the leader, no question. Hey, join me next time, remembering there's no higher calling than that of a homekeeper, or maybe a homeschool teacher.
If you would like a video copy of today's Homekeepers program for just $19.95, call 1-800-229-0059 for credit card orders, or send a gift of at least $19.95 to Homekeepers, P.O. Box 6922, Clearwater, Florida 33758. Be sure to note the program number which appears on your screen.